over 700 fender benders reported in a three-day period.
Is hot.
Dylan, what's that guy's name again? Christo?
Okay, people, here's the situation. We've got unknown terrorists, well-armed, with no demands, and seven hostages being held in the building's atrium. Can't drop you on the roof because they've got men with RPGs waiting. Can't go in on the ground because they've laid proximity mines.
30 seconds.
So we're using the hotel across the street as cover for the chopper. Bryce, Loiselle, you're gonna sit tight. Weber, cover Chavez. Domingo, you get to do the fun part. Okay, Domingo. Before I can put your team back on operational status, I need you to complete a test mission. The setting is the training warehouse, except this time, we've added a new element to the mix. You and your team will need to work closely to secure the two hostages we placed in the scenario. You can expect moderate resistance. Show me what you've got. Okay, Ding. Let's see if you still have what it takes to lead a team. In the bottom center of your screen is your team's information. Their names appear just below their current health. Above their health is their current action or status. As you can see, they are currently covering. This means that they are detached from you and ready to engage any tangos that are unlucky enough to cross their field of view. You can use the Team Hold Regroup button to have your team move to your position and follow you. Ask your team to regroup now. On the way. Good job. Now, let's give your team another order. Remember the action icon displayed above your team's information? When you look at an action location from a distance, brackets appear around it. Anytime an action icon appears with brackets, you can give an order to your team. We'll start with the simplest order you can give your team, move to. To issue a move to order, look at the area where you want your team to move and press the action button. Now, send your team to the next room by issuing a move to order.
Roger. Moving now.
Negative, sir.
Roger. Moving now.
Great. Giving move to orders also works when you look at walls and most other objects in the world. Move to the next area. Okay, now let's issue a door order. Since you don't interact with everything in the world the same way, you get a different action icon depending on where you look. For example, when you look at a door, you get a door action icon. Tell your team to open and clear the next room by looking at the door and pressing the action button.
Waiting for orders.
Roger. Open and clear.
Contact!
Threat eliminated.
As you can see, there is a bomb in this room. Order your team to disarm it by looking at the bomb and pressing the action button.
Roger. Demo up.
Nice work. Now, let's practice giving detailed orders to your team. Instead of pressing the action button to give your team an order, press and hold the action button. This brings up the Quick Order interface, which displays all of the orders you can give at this location. Give your team an open, flash, and clear order using the Quick Order interface.
Roger. Open, flash, and clear.
Better.
Huh?
Contact.
Outstanding. Flashing a room before assaulting it temporarily blinds the terrorists inside, making it easier to eliminate them. Since flashbangs do not cause damage, you should use them around hostages. Move to the next room. Order your team to secure the hostage by looking at the hostage and pressing the action button.
Roger. Securing hostage.
Nicely done. You can also give orders to your team using the Zulu Go code. This allows you to give orders to your team, which they execute
only after you've given them the Zulu go code. Once you've issued an order on Zulu, you can move to another area before issuing Zulu go code and telling your team to execute their order. This allows you to assault a room from two different directions at the same time. Give your team an order on Zulu go code on the next door.
Waiting for orders. Roger. Open flash and clear on Zulu.
Perfect. Now your team is in position and waiting for you to give them the Zulu go code. Move to the other door, give the Zulu go code, and then storm in the room at the same time as your team.
Roger. Open flash and clear.
Entabe!
Nicely done. Let's practice the Zulu go code technique again, but this time using a breach order.
Roger.
Brother?
Breach und clear on Zulu. Placing explosives. Explosives ready.
Now, move to the other door, give the Zulu go code, and storm in simultaneously with your team.
Enough.
Fire in the hole!
Contact! Threat neutralized.
Fantastic job. Breaching a door blinds the people inside the room, but also causes damage to anyone standing nearby. Always make sure hostages are away from doors before breaching them. Order your team to secure the hostage by looking at the hostage and pressing the action button.
Roger. Securing hostage.
You've done an outstanding job, Domingo. You and your team are back on operational status.
Nicely done. It's good to have your team back and fully operational. Just in time, too. We're going to need you in the next few months. Terrorists have started hitting Venezuelan targets worldwide. And while we haven't been requested yet, I have a feeling that's about to change. Throw in the fact that the dispute between the US and OPEC is escalating daily, and I think it's safe to say there will be work for your team very soon.
Boston was only one of several coordinated terrorist strikes against Venezuelan interests. Dr. Prince, what can you tell us about this most recent incident?
I think you can say that what we saw in Boston was an objection to Venezuela's foreign policy.
Was this related to OPEC's decision to impose an oil embargo against the U.S.?
Well, as you know, Venezuela is now the only OPEC member exporting oil to the United States. It's a very tense situation.
The Prime Minister has just arrived at the G8 summit in Gstaad, as has the President of Venezuela, here to discuss his nation's role in the present oil crisis. Talk of terrorism may also be on the agenda.
Here's the situation. We have two hostages inside the compound and an unknown number of terrorists. They're demanding $20 million and an end to the oil sales to the U.S. Both captives are members of the Venezuelan delegation, though President Ruiz is not on the list.
What about the other delegates?
Everyone else was let go as soon as the Swiss authorities showed up.
bad guys aren't budging on the Venezuelans, though. And that's why we're here. The situation's too hot for the locals to handle.
Let's get right down to business. We have a hostage situation in Switzerland. It seems that an unknown group of terrorists have attacked the G8 economic meeting early this morning. Things have escalated to a level where the Swiss government is formally requesting our help. The terrorists took members of the Venezuelan delegation hostage in the village near the conference and are demanding that Venezuela stop selling oil to the U.S. in exchange for their release. Obviously, both the Venezuelan and American governments are a little upset over this, especially since the terrorists took the Venezuelans hostage and let the other delegates go. The reports the local police have given us indicate that the terrorists are neither well organized nor armed. The one thing they do have in their favor is numbers. You're going to be facing roughly 3-1 odds when you go in, but I expect your training and skill to make the difference here. Take them out quickly. It's the only chance the hostages have.
I need you to move into the village and neutralize the terrorists.
Flash and clear. Clear.
Intelligence puts the first hostage somewhere in the church. Take it nice and slow.
Open, flash, and clear. Lovely scenery. Pity about all the blokes with guns.
Hostile eliminated.
Clear.
Now.
securing terrorists. Roger. Moving now.
Roger. Securing terrorist. Roger. Moving now.
Merhaba?
Careful on the road. You don't want to get caught in a crossfire.
And clear.
Intelligence puts the last hostage in the basement. Don't rush.
Biden.
Coming to you.
Excellent work, Domingo. Extract now.
Both the Venezuelan and American governments are extremely pleased with your performance. They've also got a lot of questions over who was behind this operation. It's no secret that ever since OPEC slapped that oil embargo in place, tensions between the U.S.-Venezuela alliance and the rest of the OPEC nations have been running a little high. Intel is speculating that someone with ties to another OPEC nation might be behind this. But as of now, we've got no hard evidence one way or the other.
Nice work, people. Unfortunately, we're not done yet. Some of the terrorists cut and ran before we arrived, and we're working cleanup. Fortunately, we know exactly where they are. They wiped out in a highway tunnel 20 clicks south of here, and barricaded themselves behind an overturned fuel truck. They've also pulled a couple of hostages out of stopped cars. This one's a rush job, gentlemen, so go get them.
Keep your gear on, because I'm gonna have to throw you right back into the field. It looks like a few terrorists escaped the village before the Swiss managed to get their perimeter in place. Luckily, they didn't do a good job of running. 70 clicks northeast of the village, they wiped out in a tunnel and took a few other cars with them. Now they're holed up inside the tunnel itself and have wired an overturned fuel truck with explosives. If the police go in, they blow the truck. They've also taken a pair of hostages and are threatening to kill them if they don't get a ransom and a one-way ticket out of the country. Your objectives, Domingo, are simple. The Swiss police will maintain a perimeter on the tunnel. You and your team are to enter the site, secure the hostages, and make sure that fuel truck doesn't get torched. Good luck.
Roger. Demo up.
Intel puts the first hostage somewhere inside the maintenance tunnels. Go get him.
Information.
Brother?
Flash and clear. Clear.
Enough.
Roger. Open, flash and clear. Contact. Threat eliminated. Contact. Clear.
Tango rear. Tango down.
Orders.
Flash and clear.
Contact. Tango neutralized.
Waiting for orders.
Coming to you.
Roger. Moving now.
Other side of the big wreck. Continue through the maintenance tunnels to gain access.
Contact!
Roger. Moving now.
Contact. Tango down.
Roger. Moving now.
Tango rear.
Threat neutralized.
Nice work, Domingo. I'd say this is a nice, neat wrap-up to a potentially messy operation. You and your team did a good job. By the way, the Swiss authorities are especially pleased with the lack of structural damage to the tunnel. We're still working on identifying the terrorists, but so far, intel is drawing a blank. What we do know is that we weren't dealing with real professionals here. That bomb was homemade, and some of their weapons weren't top of the line either. When we find out more, I'll let you know.
It is my great honor to introduce the man whose generosity we celebrate today, Juan Crespo.
Thank you.
This small contribution will benefit generations to come and enrich our lives. Now and always, I hope to do whatever I can for my beloved country.
In recent weeks, Venezuela has become America's primary petroleum supplier. In response to fears that Venezuelan supertankers may become terrorist targets, U.S. warships are now escorting every vessel carrying petroleum from that nation's refineries.
That little slice of paradise down there is Curaçao. It's the site of one of the world's largest oil refineries, operated by the Venezuelan National Oil Company.
What's the situation?
We've got an unknown number of hostiles in control of the refinery complex. They've got a hostage, and they've rigged the entire site with explosives. Now they're threatening to level the refinery.
Very messy.
Very lethal, too. But you knew that.
You're heading to Curaçao, but it's not for vacation. We've got an oil refinery in hostile hands, and the terrorists inside are threatening to detonate the bombs they've placed around the site unless their demands are met. They're asking for the same thing the amateurs in Switzerland wanted, an end to Venezuelan oil shipments to the U.S. That's enough to make Intel think that we're dealing with another branch of the same organization here. Just to make this even more fun, they've got a hostage, the refinery's facilities director. The terrorists have already said he'll be shot immediately if anyone comes in after them, so you know you have your work cut out for you. Go in silent and go in fast, and I'll see you when you're done.
Located near the Section A control room. Take your team there and neutralize it.
neutralized. Roger. Open, flash, and clear. Open flash and clear on Zulu. Roger. Open flash and clear.
One down, one to go. The last bomb is in the Section C machine room. It's located on the first floor.
Hostile down.
Cuidado.
Flash and clear.
Flash and clear.
Hola.
Now, camp do that, sir. Contact. Make him pay, Ding. Head down, Ding. Waiting for orders.
Roger. Ammo up.
Now that the facility's safe, I need you to rescue the site director. Surveillance puts him near a loading dock in Section E.
Flash and clear.
Hey!
Contact!
Threat eliminated.
Tango down.
Clear!
Tango rear.
Threat eliminated.
Tango rear!
Threat neutralized.
Official confirmation from Intel. The men you just dealt with are affiliated with your playmates from Switzerland. The weapons used in both attacks were traced to an Egyptian weapons shipment that was supposedly lost off the Syrian coast 6 weeks ago. The Egyptians are swearing up and down that they have no idea what happened to it, and Intel believes them. But the serial numbers on the weapons match up, and that means that the men we're facing are part of a bigger organization than we thought.
Sorry about the accommodations, gentlemen. It's the best the Dutch government could do for us on short notice. Take a good look at your next target, team. Intel has found us an exclusive party that we really ought to attend. The guest list includes the CEO of the Venezuelan state-owned oil concern and his wife. Your job will be to escort them out of there.
Formal dress?
You'll be wearing black, of course. The whole soiree is being hosted by a band of well-trained terrorists. They're covering all of the entrances to the compound, so you'll have to hit it hard and fast. I recommend using this entrance for access.
Dieter, we'll need you to clear the way.
I'm on it.
Then, gentlemen, if you're ready, go pick up your invitations in the armory.
We've got more trouble in Paradise, Domingo. When the refinery operation went sour, our terrorists went to Plan B. They're holding the CEO of the Venezuelan state-owned oil company and his wife hostage. The terrorists are asking for a huge ransom for the hostages' safe return. Psych thinks they have no intention of executing the captives. They're too valuable. But we can't count on that. And we all know that accidents happen in this sort of situation. Sending in a full team might panic the terrorists into doing something stupid. We can't risk that. Therefore, Domingo, this time it's just you and Weber. Go in fast, neutralize the hostage takers, and get the hostages out of there in one piece. Has expensive tastes, so try to keep property damage to a minimum. Intel puts the first hostage somewhere on the second floor.
Neutralized.
now. Roger. Moving now. In position. Already in position. In position. Coming to you. Formation. Roger, holding.
You've got to save me. They took my husband downstairs toward the courtyard. You have to save him.
Confirmed. The last hostage is in the courtyard. Be careful.
On the way. Information. Roger. Moving now. Contact! Information. Roger. Open flash once clear. Contact! Hostile down. Clear! Roger. Open flash once clear.
Sending in a helo to extract you and the hostages. I need you to keep the area clear until it arrives.
We'll go back against the fence.
Rainbow, this is Bear, ETA 30.
seeing some dangerous patterns forming with these attacks. They're organized, and they've got a definite goal. If these terrorist attacks cause Venezuela to stop shipping oil to the U.S., then things are going to get very interesting. Of course, that's exactly what the rest of OPEC wants, which means that we're going to see some rising tensions with the Saudis as well. I don't like this one bit.
Starting today, the sale of oil to the U.S. will cease, as those profits cannot buy back our citizens' lives. And in my next term in office...
So tell me, Emilio, how goes the campaign?
Soon, he will formally declare he is running. And when the election comes, he will win.
The people are unhappy with Ruiz?
My people do not like to think of themselves as cowards.
He will make a fine president.
I have brought you some of his campaign materials. Feel free to help us distribute them.
Welcome to Venezuela, gentlemen. Several hours ago, a large band of terrorists infiltrated the shipyard in Puerto Cabello. Their profile indicates that this may be the same group we've been dealing with since Boston.
Any hostages?
Intel confirms we're in the clear there. The terrorists have wired the entire facility to blow. They want 50 million, or they pull the trigger. I'd rather you went in to negotiate with them personally. The Puerto Cabello shipyard is the largest one in Venezuela, and it's currently engaged in building tankers for the country's national oil company. It only makes sense that it would be a tempting target for the terrorists we've been dealing with since Switzerland. Wreck the shipyard and you cripple Venezuela's ability to export oil for years to come. What we have in front of us right now is the worst case scenario. Terrorists took control of the shipyard 6 hours ago and have rigged the entire site with massive explosive charges. If their ransom demands aren't met, they'll level the entire facility. Intel suspects that even if the terrorists get what they want, the shipyard's going to have an accident. So you and your team get to provide an alternative solution. Your mission is simple. Regain control of the facility and secure all of the explosives. Expect heavy resistance, as this is the sort of prize that terrorists aren't likely to give up without a fight.
Need this shipyard intact. The first bomb is in the warehouse to your front. Be careful, you're heading into a real maze.
Orders. Roger. Moving now.
Clancy,
Roger. Climbing ladder. To you. Roger. Open flash and clear.
Nice work. According to intel, the second bomb is below you, near a machine room.
Coming to you. Roger. Moving now.
Room, the bombs can't be far.
Hello?
Roger, moving now. Second bomb located.
We are...
Stakes got a lot higher as soon as the threat hit Venezuelan soil. Their economy's already soft, and oil exports are the only thing propping it up right now. Any interference with those exports could cause a crisis, And in the meantime, Washington is screaming blue murder about the latest outbreak of terrorist activity. Things are heating up out there, and we still aren't any closer to putting these guys out of business. I'm telling you, Domingo, I have a nasty feeling that the situation's gonna get worse. A lot worse, before it gets better.
Ladies and gentlemen, the President of the United States.
My fellow Americans, I stand before you in a time when terror serves as currency in the laws of international diplomacy. It is the responsibility of all who love freedom to fight against such tactics. To the men who perpetrated the acts of terror on American soil and who strike against the people of our sister nation, Venezuela, I call you cowards. If these events continue, the American people will respond swiftly and forcefully.
Gentlemen, terrorists have occupied the Crespo Children's Foundation office in Montreal, Canada. Crespo's been making a lot of noise in Venezuelan politics about getting the oil flowing back to America. His people are behind him. The terrorists want him dead.
The Montreal office? It has nothing to do with oil.
Crespo was due there for a monthly board meeting. However, his flight was delayed and the bad guys missed him. They've taken other hostages instead and want to make a trade for the man himself. This is not an option.
From their communications with the Quebecois authorities, the terrorists' real objective was Juan Crespo himself. It appears that his anti-terrorism and pro-US sentiments have put him on our friend's shortlist. Now for the bad news. Although they failed to get Crespo, the terrorists did manage to take over the Crespo Foundation headquarters in Montreal and take several members of the board of directors hostage. They're demanding either an insane ransom or Juan Crespo's head in return for their hostages. Obviously, they're not getting either, so I need you to take your team in and neutralize those tangos.
This is an international children's charity, so all eyes are on us. The first hostage is somewhere on the second floor.
Contact!
Run!
Contact!
Hostile eliminated.
Roger. Moving now.
Coming to you. With you, sir. Roger. Moving now. Roger, moving now. Roger. Moving now.
Hey!
Contact!
Waiting for orders. On the way. Coming through. Open back
and flash and clear. Roger. Open flash and clear.
Hey!
Taking fire! Grenade! Under fire!
Roger. Open flash and clear.
Run!
Information.
Contact. Taking fire!
Hey!
Roger. Securing hostages.
Thank God you're here.
Don't worry. You're safe now.
Intel puts the next hostage on the third floor. Be careful.
Ayúdenme.
Flash and clear on Zulu. Roger. Open Flash and clear. And clear.
The U.S. State Department just passed us a message through channels. It reads, "The future president of Venezuela wants to personally thank the agency responsible for putting an end to the terrorist crisis in Montreal. It's polite of him, but we have bigger fish to fry. There were two car bombings in the Middle East this morning, and it looks like there's a Saudi Arabian connection. Saudis are claiming they're clean, and tempers are getting hot. If people aren't careful, this could turn into a shooting war real fast. Closer to home, one of the terrorists you brought in cut himself a deal after a couple of hours talking to Syke. Unfortunately, he didn't know much in the way of operational details. All our prisoner had was this. There's something big planned on U.S. soil, and it's coming soon. It's clear that these goons have good internal security in place, and that means they're more professional than they've shown so far. Both of these things worry me.
Here to pick up a delicate package. The cargo is Nusrat Aman, a Saudi national who feeds us useful intel while holding connections with several potentially active terrorist cells. This is the man who clued us into the Boston operation.
Remind me to thank him.
You'll get a chance to do it personally. His last communique indicated that his cover had been blown. We need to extract him before someone closes his file permanently.
This operation is extremely time-sensitive. Let me explain, and you'll see what I'm talking about here. One of our best informants, a man who's tapped into a half dozen terrorist networks throughout the world, sent a message 3 days ago that he had extremely important information concerning the Venezuela situation. He also said he was quite certain that if we didn't reel him in quickly, he'd be killed. Bring our fish in, Domingo. We need this man's information desperately. We can't afford to let him be killed. This may be the key to the whole operation, if you can get him out alive.
Exactly sure where the informer is, but we do know that the area is overrun with tangos. A good place to start is to check out his last known location, his house in the center of town. Keep your eyes open.
Roger. Moving now. Waiting for orders. We have contact. Low. Roger. Moving now. In position. Can't do that, sir. Finding one man in this maze will be difficult. Negative, sir. Already in position. Now. now. Negative, sir. On the way. Information. Roger. Moving now. And clear. Contact. Orders. Yeah. Roger.
In the next room. Remember, we need him alive.
Roger. Open flash and clear on Zulu. Flash and clear. 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 Roger. Securing hostage.
Excellent work. Hopefully your pickup will be able to shed some light on this mess. Excellent work. You handled that one perfectly. Now let me tell you what our informant told Intel. The first name he gave up was Emilio Vargas. If that sounds familiar, it's because he's Juan Crespo's right-hand man and confidant. Apparently Vargas is dirtier than an old dish rag. He's got some suspicious-looking financial ties to some Middle Eastern organizations that Intel's looking into. And he also was apparently behind the smash and grab in Boston. Papers that were taken out of the basement vault were records of financial transactions that would have blown the lid off this thing. As of now, we're not really sure what game he's playing. We do know that he's close to Crespo, and that Crespo's probably going to be the next president of Venezuela. And that means he's worth keeping a very close eye on.
Way to get in touch with them, Six.
Sorry to throw you right back into the fire, but Loisel and Weber are in trouble in Trieste, and you're the closest backup we've got. They've gone to ground, but there are a lot of tangos on the street looking for them, and they can't hide forever. I hate to do this to you guys, but we have an emergency situation. Loisel and Weber are in trouble in Trieste, and you're the closest help available. They were supposed to be running a recon mission parallel to yours, but our intel was faulty, and they ran into heavier resistance than expected. It looks like the intelligence we received was a plant, and this whole operation was a setup. But that doesn't matter now. Last time we heard from the team, they were finding a place to hole up and defend. That was a few minutes ago. Since then, we've lost radio contact. Your objective is simple. Go in there with Price and bring Loisel and Weber back on the double. Expect heavy resistance and keep your team intact. We don't have anyone else to send in after you. We'll be right back. lost their signal several minutes ago. Their last call came from a small room on the second floor of a building near your location. Get there fast.
Roger. Moving now. Coming to you. Negative, sir. Roger. Moving now.
Cuidado.
Waiting for orders. Roger. Moving now.
Cuidado. Consigan más ayuda.
Can't do that, sir. Roger. Moving now.
Guys know what they're doing. They probably just moved to a safer position. There's a likely location near the market. The satellite has spotted lots of activity around that building. Tango Rio! We've got their signal. They're inside that building. Communication should be functional again.
Now, we should be safe from the deliverance.
melt down.
Waiting for orders.
What are you doing? Your men are in... Good job. It's nice to see the team intact again. Intel will work on identifying those terrorists. It's clear they're not as isolated as we originally believed. My gut says that their trail will lead us right to our other playmates. And I've got a nasty feeling we'll hear from them again soon.
Despite its image, Alcatraz was actually a prison for only 30-odd years. It got shut down in 1963.
And how is it that such a perfect holding tank for evil men now only traps tourists?
More evil men. Politicians felt it was too expensive to run.
Sometimes money is not as important as what one can accomplish with it.
They missed Crespo in Montreal, but they got him in San Francisco. The man who's probably going to be the next president of Venezuela is now a hostage on U.S. soil, and Washington is very nervous. We've trained you on how to break out of any number of prisons, Domingo, but this may be the first time you have to sneak into one. Our friend Juan Crespo was in San Francisco conducting some business and wanted to take the VIP tour of Alcatraz while he was there. Unfortunately, looks like someone else had a copy of his itinerary. Someone hit his party mid-tour. They took out the bodyguards fast, but Crespo's being held for ransom along with a tour guide somewhere in the prison complex. I recommend that you take your team into the prison from below using the old sewer tunnel system. Intel is working on pinpointing Crespo's exact location, but there's no time to lose. If Crespo's killed, the repercussions will be huge and unpleasant. Now you see why no one's ever escaped from this place. You'll be going in through the sewer system, so stay sharp.
Negative, sir. With you, sir. Roger, moving now. the way. Roger. Moving now. Roger. Open, flash, and clear. Clear.
Can't do that, sir.
Cuidado.
Roger. Moving now.
Roger. Moving now.
Roger. Securing hostage.
I just finished debriefing Crespo. He has nothing but good things to say about Vargas. Oddly enough, he has no idea where Vargas is right now, and is as curious as we are about that fact. Intel is already working on the paper trail, and as soon as we find a likely location, you and your men will be going in.
Charles, how do things look from where you're standing?
We've been told that this military exercise was planned months in advance. The number of surveillance aircraft flying sorties has been increasing, though. And some of those flights come close to Saudi airspace.
Do you feel there's any connection between the President's comments and what you're seeing?
The President is concerned about Riyadh's ability to get tough with Saudi-based terror groups. He's sending a message. Either the Saudis remove terror from their soil, or the U.S. will step in and do it for them.
Emilio Vargas has worked behind the scenes on Team Crespo for 12 years, but it looks like he's been moonlighting. Information provided by Aman tied him to the bank papers stolen in Boston. Intel followed up and found links to possible terrorist slush funds as well, but we don't have anything solid yet. Domingo, I need you to find me a smoking gun. Intel took a long look into Emilio Vargas' banking practices and found all sorts of interesting things. He's got links to a handful of suspected terrorist slush funds in the Middle East, for one thing. That's what Boston was about, by the way. The records in the basement were a red flag as to what was really going down. That being said, we need more first-hand information, and Intel's pinpointed what they think is a good place to get it. I need you and your team to go into an import-export firm owned by Vargas and secure the site's contents so Intel can see what's going on. Odds are that the people running the company aren't going to take your visit well, so be prepared to defend yourself if you meet resistance. Evidence, not a body count, but make sure you defend yourselves.
Roger, moving now. Now. Roger. Open, flash, and clear.
Finding the weapons. Now you get to go looking for the real dirt.
Waiting for orders.
Cuidado!
Negative, sir.
Roger. Moving now.
Contact.
Roger. Moving now.
Cuidado. Wait.
waiting for orders.
Contact!
Outstanding. This is exactly what we need to move on Vargas. Wrap this mission up by securing the rest of the facility.
Assault eliminated. Contact!
Congratulations. You've got intel more excited than a kid on his first date. We expected to find weapons and incriminating records in that warehouse, but the chemical barrels were a surprise. I've got the lab doing a full spectrum of tests on them now. We need to know what they're holding and what it was going to be used for. It's time we got a little closer to Vargas to find out what he's up to.
My countrymen, the eyes of the world have turned to our nation, and what they see has made me so proud. You have called for an end to fear. Today, we will step out from the shadow of terror and into the warm light of freedom.
Nice work, but you opened up a whole new can of worms. The chemicals you found are components for VX nerve gas.
I liked them better when they were just blowing up shipyards.
So did I. Nothing we've seen indicates that Vargas wants mass slaughter. And again, Vargas has been hard to find since the election. Domingo, it's time you paid him a house call. Vargas has probably heard about the import-export company by now. And if he's got half a brain in his head, he's not going to come home. I'm gambling that he's going to want to talk to somebody there, though. And that's where you come in, Domingo. This one's a solo mission, and you're going in with only a pistol. You need to get in, bug the place, and get out. We need to hear what Vargas is saying, and we need to see what he's been doing on his computer. Once we have that, we can turn this thing around. Here is to get in and out without being seen. That means no shooting. Your first objective is to bug the phone on the second floor. I'm sending you terrorist positions on your map, but I don't know how long it's going to last. Okay, Ding. Now I need you to bug Vargas' computer in his office. It's located just down the hall from where you are now. Looks like there's someone Intel didn't account for. He matches the description of Vargas' accountant. Evade him and proceed to the alternate computer terminal in the master bedroom. Domingo, hold your position. We're already receiving intel from the phone bug. Okay, here's what we've got. That was Vargas on the phone telling one of his thugs to take out the accountant. What I need you to do is get him out of there. If he's important enough for Vargas to want dead, then we need to talk to him. Your weapons are free. Fire at will.
Escort the accountant to your insertion point. I'm sending a helo to pick you up there.
Things are getting uglier everywhere, but that accountant you rescued gives us a little hope. He's been giving us everything we want on Vargas and more, and he's already tipped us off to a potential storage site for more nerve gas ingredients. You heard me right. The barrels in the warehouse were full of a precursor for VX gas, which is not something we want Vargas to get his hands on. And with relations between the US and the Saudis getting worse by the minute, the last thing we need is a nerve gas attack. It would be too easy for someone to use that as a way to tip this thing into war.
In a surprising move, newly elected Venezuelan President Juan Crespo has called an emergency OPEC meeting. In the wake of Crespo's stated refusal to go along with OPEC policy, many skeptics are wondering why.
Greetings, my old friend.
And congratulations to the next great leader of Venezuela, and OPEC's new favorite son.
From the moment I arrived, I have felt a deep concern for the plight of your people. The policies of the United States cannot be supported.
An incredible humanitarian effort.
And a sensational opportunity for us to make billions.
From the moment your plane landed, the price of oil began to rise.
And the black market is anxiously awaiting Venezuela's output. How goes the rest of your plan?
Your associate reports he will be arriving in Louisiana shortly. Then we shall see what a true oil panic looks like.
According to the accountant pulled out of Vargas's penthouse, we've been chasing the wrong man. Crespo's going to put most of Venezuela's oil production on the international black market and skim the profit for himself. We still don't know where the VX fits in. That's not good. Vargas' accountant has been a big help. The first thing he did was finger a meatpacking plant his former boss owned as another storage site for material for the nerve gas. He's currently talking to Intel about a few other things, but it's the VX that concerns us. Domingo, you and your team are going to be dropped by chopper about a half mile away, so you'll be inserting on foot. There are civilians in the plant, so treat this as a potential hostage situation. Good luck. Nice and slow. If they see you coming, they'll most likely take hostages to slow you down.
Hola.
Thermal satellite imagery is showing a lot of activity down there. It looks like they've taken two hostages, so I need you to secure them before continuing your search for chemicals.
Waiting for orders.
Orders.
Roger, moving now.
Are you lost?
Moving now. Roger. Flashbang. Roger. Moving now.
Corran!
Huh?
Orders. I am alive.
Roger, securing hostage. Nice job. The second hostage appears to be upstairs in a room with two large storage tanks. Clear.
securing hostage.
Oh.
Now you can get back to why you're really here. Find those chemicals.
Good work. You handled that perfectly. The skinny on the situation is this. We've got most of their stockpile, but it's clear from the records you confiscated that some of the VX is already on its way to the United States. The stuff dissolves easily in organic solvents, so finding it's going to be a real bear. Intel's already looking for that, and for Vargas. I have a feeling that when we find one, we'll find the other.
Four hours ago, a cargo ship docked in New Orleans. Customs went over the boat with a fine-tooth comb, but didn't find anything. They did, however, take these photos. That's Vargas, and if he's in the U.S., something big is about to go down. Go get him.
U.S. Customs found Vargas for us a few hours ago, though they didn't manage to contain him. He was on board a cargo ship that docked in New Orleans early this morning and immediately started offloading its load, automobiles. Intel's convinced that the cars are the key to the VX. They may be right. Customs put a tail on Vargas and tracked him to a garage in the city. Now it's time for you to go dig him out. Be very careful on this one, Domingo. VX is vicious stuff.
Stay sharp. We need Vargas alive. Locate and secure him.
Hola. Cuidado!
Roger. Open, flash, and clear. On the way.
policía. Hey!
Get ready, Domingo. We're going to need to move fast. This thing doesn't end with Vargas. He's claiming that Crespo is the one behind all of this, and that he's in cahoots with a Saudi dissident who wants to use the oil crisis as a way to grab power. Crespo's plan was to use the oil issue to become president of Venezuela, then do an about-face and cut off the U.S. oil supply. He'd keep selling it, of course, but on the black market so he could rake in a huge personal profit. Meanwhile, he'd work with his mysterious friend to mount terrorist attacks against the United States and let the Saudis take the blame for it. When the U.S. stepped in, Crespo's friend would take over in Riyadh. It's nasty, and it's clever. We don't have much time to stop it. Vargas told us what the VX is for. They shipped it in by hiding it in the radiators of those cars, then pumped it out and took it downtown. If we don't stop Crespo's men, they're going to turn it loose on the Mardi Gras parade, and we're going to have tens of thousands of casualties.
That was fast.
Sometimes we get lucky. Vargas didn't even wait for us to offer a deal.
Anything good?
Good intel? Bad news. Crespo's aligned himself with a Saudi dissident who wants to prod the U.S. into war. They're real bosom buddies. Crespo cuts off the oil, while the Saudi hits the U.S. with terror operations. Crespo makes billions selling oil to the U.S. through a third party at the higher price, and the Saudi waits until a U.S. assault enables him to make his play for power while the bombs are falling. And then they come out on top, just in time to get rebuilt. Suit your team up. We found the VX. It's at Mardi Gras. We have more details on what Crespo's intending to do with the VX. He's managed to conceal a concussion device strapped to the VX canisters on one of the parade floats. At a predetermined time during the parade, he's going to detonate the bomb and disperse the gas throughout the city. Failure is simply not an option, Domingo. I need you to find that bomb and defuse it before this city gets turned into a graveyard. There's no one I trust more. Go to it.
area is tight. Keep your head on a swivel. The bomb should be located inside a Mardi Gras float.
Ayúdenme!
Behind a cover. I'll disarm that device.
Attend to that, sir.
Policía! Olvido! Policía!
Intel puts the failed... Ding, you've got 3 minutes.
Hey!
Now all we need to do is get Crespo, and we can wrap this thing up.
Today, you were a hero. We have the VX, and New Orleans is safe. You could not have done it better. And to go with your good work, it looks like the tensions are easing between the US and Saudi Arabia. Looks like Crespo's friend is out of luck, too. Now all you have to do is take care of the source of the problem. It's time to find Crespo and tie this whole thing up once and for all. Gentlemen, we now have only one piece of unfinished business. Juan Crespo. Officially, he's still the president of Venezuela. Unofficially, he's been disavowed. Caracas has requested we resolve the situation quietly. Also, Intel estimates he's still got the last of the VX with him. We need to find him, and we need to make sure he never gets the chance to use that gas. Think about what that means. And in the meantime, the president has something to say about your work.
Today, brave men prevented a brazen act of terrorism. This planned attack was part of an effort to strain relations between the United States and the people of Saudi Arabia. Let it be known that the United States will not be manipulated by terror, nor goaded into war. In response, representatives of the Saudi government pledged to hunt down terrorists within their own borders and have asked OPEC to reconsider the oil embargo.
Crespo's been located, and according to intel, he's got a last reservoir of VX with him. It's in solution for transport, but that just means it's not immediately dangerous. Facts of the matter are that Crespo and the VX both need to be dealt with. At this point, it doesn't look like arresting him is an option. He's going to be trying to escape in a small aircraft from a private field outside Caracas. Domingo, I'm sending just you in. Don't let him or that nerve gas get away. Sees you before the explosives are planted or the mission's over. No shooting.
Outstanding. Now that the insurance policy is in place, I need you to find Crespo. You are weapons free. I repeat, weapons free. Fire at will. just got a visual on Crespo leaving the firehouse. Stay on it. It's over. Be proud. Be damn proud. You did good work. Better than anyone will ever know. Remember that. And hold your head high. The world owes you one.
A truly great man, Juan Crespo. He died for what he often referred to as his heart, the nation of Venezuela. Now he is a martyr to the very terror he fought. May he be its final victim.